Welcome to the 2012 Republican Party of Iowa State Convention.
Republicans from across the state Saturday gathered in Des Moines for their annual convention, and party chairman A.J. Spiker tried to set the tone for the event.
With the commitment of delegates, like all of you, our party is stronger and more energized heading into the November elections.
And the statesman of the party, U.S. Senator Charles Grassley, tried to keep up the effort to get Republicans who may still be bitter over the presidential race to come together.
Just about 140 days from now, you and I are going to help elect four Iowa congressmen. We're going to fight to make sure we get a majority in both houses of the state legislature, and we're going to make Romney president of the United States and save this country.
But when the convention got into full swing, Mitt Romney's name was never mentioned again. Instead, it was Ron Paul getting all the attention. The biggest coup was when Paul supporters managed to get picked for seats on the committee that decides who goes to the Republican National Convention in Palm Beach, Florida, from Iowa. With majority control of the delegate selection committee and with the party's chair being the Ron Paul Iowa campaign manager, the committee easily put forward a slate of delegates that all support Ron Paul, with the exception of Senator Charles Grassley and Governor Terry Branstad. That met with vocal opposition on the floor of the convention.
I think that Rick Santorum won Iowa in January, that his supporters have an awful lot to add to this party, and that it's a mistake to not have a single Rick Santorum supporter as a delegate to the national convention. That's just not fair.
But the Paul supporters vocally defended their slate of delegates.
The first slate was put together by duly elected nominating committee. This slate was also published with plenty of time for everyone to vet the people that are on the slate.
In the end, the Ron Paul slate of delegates was approved by a 105-vote margin. Paul supporters also had their influence on the party platform with planks that opposed genetically modified crops and bioengineered agriculture and supported a constitutional amendment that would mandate voter initiatives similar to what California has and allowing recalls of elected officials, what Wisconsin just endured. Somewhat rancorous debate over the party's platform ended in the early evening hours, when there weren't enough delegates in the convention hall for a quorum. Gary Barrett, News Radio 1040 WHO on the web.